Good evening and welcome to 10 News. His small step changed the world, and tonight Neil Armstrong is being remembered across the globe. The 82-year-old died from complications following heart bypass surgery earlier this month. As tributes flow for the reluctant hero, our US Bureau Chief Emma Dallimore has all the latest from the States, while Amber Muir is at Sydney's Observatory Hill, where many have today paid their respects. We'll go first to Emma. Neil Armstrong described himself as a nerdy engineer, but to the world he was much more than that.
Matt, he was so much more. Those famous footprints on the moon's surface inspired generations of people to look toward the sky and to dream big. Today, President Barack Obama said that Neil Armstrong was among America's greatest heroes, not just of his time, but of all time.
It's one small step for man, one giant leap for mankind.
Words etched in history from a man who truly left his mark.
It's an interesting place to be. I recommend it.
It was 1969 when a 38-year-old Neil Armstrong took those historic steps, beginning a 2-hour and 21-minute walk with friend Buzz Aldrin that one in every six people on Earth were watching.
Here, man, from the planet Earth, first set foot upon the moon.
Armstrong was always a dreamer. He grew up in the 30s with air travel in its infancy and space just science fiction. But he was fascinated by flight. He got a pilot's license before he could drive a car, and after enrolling in an aerospace engineering course, was sent to Korea flying 78 missions in Navy Panther jets. Then NASA came calling, and Armstrong tested new aircraft right to the edge of space. After President Kennedy declared Americans would land on the moon within a decade, Armstrong became an astronaut. On his first mission, commanding the Gemini 8, a thruster malfunctioned, but a calm Armstrong guided his team to safety. Then, planning for the moon landing, Armstrong ejected as the aircraft plummeted.
When it was all over, you went back to your office and sat down to do paperwork.
That's true. I did. There was work to be done.
Then after 6 years of training, Apollo 11 blasted off. Carrying the hopes of a nation in the middle of the Cold War, after 4 days came their first transmission.
Tranquility Base here. The Eagle has landed.
And an image for the history books.
It was the ultimate peaceful competition.
Armstrong returned a hero, but was a reluctant one till the end. Today, Buzz Aldrin said, even on the moon, we were never alone. I will miss my friend.
It's just so shocking to me today when someone called me early on, because you just don't want to see these great heroes go.
NASA's administrator says we enter the next era of space exploration, standing on the shoulders of Neil Armstrong.
Do what he did, be the first person to ever set foot, ever make a footprint on some place other than Earth, is to me just one of the big steps in history. And we're fortunate to be living in that time when it occurred in our time.
It's unlikely there'll ever be a history book without his name in it. But Neil Armstrong's family say if you ever want to remember him, just stare toward the smiling moon and give him a wink.
Okay, Emma Dallimore in Los Angeles, thank you. Now to Amber Muir, who's at Sydney's Observatory Hill. Amber, Australia's joined in world tributes to Neil Armstrong.
Yes, Matt, the flags have been flying at half-mast here at Sydney Observatory out of respect for Neil Armstrong, and people have been streaming in all day to watch a special screening of his moon landing. The original broadcast was viewed by more than 500 million people around the world and will forever link Australia to that historic occasion, as we provided one of the key transmission points for the vision out of a station in the rural town of Parkes in New South Wales.
As news of Neil Armstrong's death travelled, people stopped to reflect where they were the day he took those famous steps into the history books.
We remember we were in Switzerland that day and listened to it in French.
We all watched it in a large, big area of our school, so we all sat there and watched him take his first steps.
We had the one black and white television in the school mounted up on a couple of tables so it could be seen. Everybody was in this courtyard sitting all day just watching, with quite tense excitement.
For Dr. Kerry Doherty, it inspired her career choice as an expert in space technology. Today, she in turn passed on that enthusiasm to a whole new generation at Sydney's Powerhouse Museum.
He was the first person on the moon, and that's like, he put the flag up there. It's amazing.
And now it looks like space is once again the key topic of interest at schools this week.
What will you tell your class about?
What age he was and stuff, and all that kind of thing, where he went, when he landed and stuff.
The images of Neil Armstrong's moon landing forever changed the way many saw their place in the world, and Australia played a big part in their broadcast. A telecommunications station using a 1,000-ton dish in the middle of a sheep paddock in New South Wales tracked and beamed most of the Apollo 11 mission. An Australian was also the last to interview the notoriously media-shy Armstrong just last year.
The greatest legacy Neil Armstrong leaves is the message he leaves to young people. And if they look at the footage of going from Earth to the moon and back with less technology than a mobile, of which they relate, I think it's an extraordinary story.
These youngsters have already got Armstrong's first lines down pat. Well, almost.
Yeah. One giant step for mankind, for man's best friends.
They might need to watch the landing one more time.
And Prime Minister Julia Gillard has also acknowledged the astronaut's passing, saying, "I salute Neil Armstrong and the explorers who have followed him for his example of service, accomplishment and modesty. His triumph of reason and science and knowledge and wisdom will never die." So those sentiments no doubt shared across the country today.
Absolutely. Amber Muir in Sydney. Thank you.